you asked me what my thoughts were on politics a year ago, or even at the beginning of last semester for that matter, I probably wouldn't have been able to give you a true stance on either party or on the candidates. And that's because it wasn't until late November last year that my close friend of mine brought up a motivational YouTube video of Bernie Sanders one night. And as I watched him digress from one big topic to the next, I couldn't believe what he planned to do as president. I completely agree with his stance on every issue he spoke about. And once the video had ended, my friend and I instantly started engaging into lengthy discussions over universal health care, student loan debt, climate change, and how European countries handle these issues. And that's all what Bernie had mentioned in the video. And ever since that night, my friend and I have been much more involved in the politics following this year's election. Because looking into a candidate that invokes serious change like no other is what really inspires us to stay involved. And of that serious change, free public college tuition is one of the strongest policies that I support. Because my brother, who has now completed 4 years of public college education, now finds himself facing over $50,000 of student loan debt. And with my parents' signatures on that paperwork too, I've had to watch my dad write out check after check just to keep my brother's regular payments up to date so that he doesn't collect even more interest on that debt. And these are thoughts that constantly burn on my mind as I plan to go to IUPUI next year. Because I don't know about all of you, but I'd love nothing more than just to be able to go to college, graduate, get my degree, and then find a career without having to worry about thousands of dollars of student loan debt that I may too have to struggle to repay. And it's this sort of thing that brought me to the conclusion that we actually can have free public college tuition within even the next year if our federal government would just redirect our nation's income towards education, because the money is there. And the source of this problem usually starts with how people nowadays think about our government, and everyone generally seems to share this idea that our federal government is using our taxpaying money wisely by allocating the funds to areas where America needs it most. And sometimes we often hear about these massive efforts the federal government makes to improve our education system, like referencing Atlas's overview of the federal government's higher education programs in 2014. We've heard that $99.7 billion was given up in student loans. Another $30.2 billion was given up in grants, and an additional $36.5 billion was spent on tax benefits, and whereas another $980 million was spent towards work study programs. And with the rest of the budget going to areas such as agriculture, transportation, scientific research, the military, Medicare, etc., our country does appear to be doing better now than it was since the Great Recession in 2008. And after all, that terrible recession did end officially in June 2009, right? Well, the reality of the situation is far from how good all this really seems. Because if you think about it like this, if all those billions of dollars we just put in, well, in 2014 that we put into those financial aid programs, if that really worked to fix the situation, would we still be over $1 trillion in debt with student loans nationally as of today? No. And I can tell you why. It's because the federal government is allocating way too much of our taxpaying money towards the military and towards financial aid programs that aren't even working. And it's even more ridiculous when you realize that some of these funds, just some of them, could fix our student loan debt crisis once and for all. And looking back to last year's budget, $600 billion was spent on the military alone, which is about 54% of the $1.1 trillion budget. And what makes this a little bit worse is that Jordan Weissman from The Atlantic stated that all the money we would have needed to provide free public college education in 2014 was only $62.6 billion. Think about that. That's only 10% of the military budget from last year. And let's not forget how we poured over $167 billion from those financial aid programs in 2014, like I mentioned. And from what I've seen, much less than half of that would have covered the cost of providing free public college education that year. And the situation is even more sad when you look at all the benefits our nation would receive from this. Michelle Simmons, a prestigious graduate from UCLA, writes, "America itself suffers as we now have an economy with an entire class of people unable to participate in it. If people have no money due to student loan debt, people can't buy stuff, can they? And meanwhile, European young people are achieving their dreams through accessible education. Those nations benefit from this, as they are growing a class of people not saddled with debt, and are therefore capable of contributing to the economy. Not to mention, you have an educated populace, a good foundation upon which future generations will flourish. So with the majority of us being high school graduates or being soon to be high school graduates, I don't really feel like I need to stress just how important this hall really is to us. And quoting Jeff Bryant, a petitioner on creditmobilize.com, it is crucial that we understand that making public colleges tuition free and preventing future debt isn't just a smart investment in our future, it's less expensive than what our federal government spends to make college affordable now. And let me ask you this, are you comfortable with the fact that even if you apply much of your time to applying to numerous scholarships and other forms of financial aid, that the odds are you're still going to find yourself with a gap in your tuition funding, and that you will start your very own accumulation of student loan debt within just the beginning of a few months? I think that is downright absurd, considering how practical free public education really is. So, now that you've been hit with all the details, I simply ask of all of you to donate towards a civil campaign, join an organization, sign a petition to send to the national government, vote for someone like Bernie Sanders, or even just spread this knowledge to others. Because only then can you rest assured that you at least made an effort to make our future a brighter one. One without the fear of uncertainty, and one where we can live happily without the burdens of debt weighing down on our shoulders. And absolutely, never forget how possible this concept really is. Because as Jeff Bryant said, the money is there, but the leadership isn't. Maybe. I think with all the money that we could redirect to it, I mean, if we just did the bare minimum, we'd still have extra money left over from all these failed financial programs we're already using. So if teachers weren't getting paid enough or professors weren't getting paid enough, we could always just redirect more to them so that they're still encouraged by the money. And one thing I think is that you were saying requirements. I think all colleges, how they are today, should just keep the requirements still so that, I mean, maybe they can raise them if they expect higher standards now since it's free. But I mean, yeah, they should set their standards however they feel is necessary for students to attend their college.
So with the free like college, like would it be just like the education, like books and like classes and stuff, or could you get like room and board and all that kind of stuff?
I think this would be solely tuition. We can maybe look at the cost of the others. I mean, that could easily like double it or add like 1.5 times that amount. So that might be a bit much more to deal with. But I mean, just going tuition would drastically affect like participation rates in colleges now. And we'd have a lot more educated people.
Would this apply to just like in-state schools, or like if you wanted to go anywhere in the U.S.?
Well, I see that since tuition, because tuition now is based on if you're in or out of state, if it was free to all colleges, yeah, you could go anywhere you want as long as they accept your requirements and your, like, your, like, your resume. So, yeah, out of state wouldn't be a thing anymore, really. Yep.
Would it be public or private schools or both?
Just public. Because there's only institutions run by like the federal government and already funded by them, but maybe private schools could seek out aid from them since they're already working towards the public schools. That could be a possibility. Yeah.
But like kind of like with what Tristan said, so if everyone is getting a degree, will that decrease the value of it?
I don't think so, because if you're qualified in like, I think they can make the requirements to get that degree even harder, make it more rigorous. So since you're not worrying about debt, and you can just focus solely on school, and you won't even have to work as much that way in college to have to pay off your debt. So you can spend more time towards academics and really prove that you're worth that degree and that you've earned it. And then more jobs can open up and that you can apply for those fields. Candidates? Well, I know the Republicans, I don't really follow them too in depth. I don't really follow politics at all anymore, really, because Bernie's chances are pretty. think Republicans are really looking at this issue as much as, say, Bernie. And I feel like Hillary is probably looking at it more now, or saying things about it to gain votes. But yeah, I know, aside from candidates, Elizabeth Warren is a senator somewhere from New England, like up in northern US. And I know she's been pressing for this for a long time. So she's one person. Yeah.
So if we take away tuition costs, do you think schools are going to mark up more of like room and board and all that stuff so they get more money that way?
They definitely could. I think that's more up to them. If they're getting an influx of students and then supplies do get really tight, then yeah, I could see them definitely marketing up. If the demand is so high, I could see that being a possibility for sure. For you.
With the public schools being, if they were free tuition, do you think they would go more towards private or not? Like, so that they weren't free, would they go to public so that they, or private so that they would have to pay? Does that make sense?
It would be.
Since the public schools are free tuition, would they change to private schools? Like become private?
I'm not sure what process that would involve. I know for like top 10 or Ivy League schools, that would probably be nearly impossible to do, to be based on religious structure. So, I don't think a lot of colleges would do that on purpose. Maybe some federal public colleges would do that if they did kind of represent religion, but they're not supposed to. So I don't think that would be a big issue.
All right, we're gonna have to be done. Thank you.